I'm happy to be able to explain a little bit about why I know about Ethiopia. There's lots of things I don't know about Ethiopia, but I've spent my whole life loving Ethiopia. And right now I'm volunteering to create books in Ethiopian languages and English because I love Ethiopia. It started all the way back when I was a kid. I was born in Portland, Oregon. That's my sister who's so cute, and I'm the other one. But my family decided to move to the continent of Africa when I was only 2 years old. Here I am in England on the way to Ethiopia, and I'm the one on a leash. That's because I always got in trouble, just like Tekla. In Ethiopia, we learned how to eat new things like Watan Injera. We had new sounds around us like hyenas at night. And I had a baby sister that was born. When she was just a baby, we got in an airplane that was very rattly. And when that airplane landed, it landed on the hot savanna. But before it could even land, it had to go around and get the ostriches and zebras out of the way. Sometimes people think I grew up on the hot savanna, but we would spend all day going up into the high and beautiful mountains of Ethiopia. And I loved living in Ethiopia as a kid. That's where I learned how to read. That's where I learned how to love books. When I was 7, we came to visit in the United States for a year. That was really strange because so many people did not know anything about Ethiopia. So I felt like an outsider. The one really good thing that happened that year was that I got a baby brother. In a lot of my books, you'll see big sister, little brother, big sister, little brother, because we write about what we know about. He was only a few months old when we went back to Ethiopia, and he got very cute, and he's still cute, but he's even taller than I am now. When he grew up, he took his own family back to Ethiopia, and he taught there. That's when I started learning more about Ethiopia as an adult. And one of the things I learned was that in Ethiopia, as well as in America, kids really wanted to have books. You know, books and education are one of the ways we share our best ideas. I've written a lot of different books, including this one that is my newest picture book. And it shares ideas about things that are important to saving the earth. It's in more than one language, so I know that books can travel all over the world. I don't know if there are ideas that you think are really powerful, but for me, one of those ideas is school. This little girl wouldn't have had a chance to go to school, except that her father was the foreman who helped build this school in rural Ethiopia. And I helped raise money for that school because I think school is so important. You know, when I was a kid, girls, my friends, didn't get a chance to go to school. So now when I visit Ethiopia, it's really thrilling to see girls as well as boys getting a chance to go to school. I've also helped plant a lot of libraries in Ethiopia. Some of them have a building, but some of them are out in the open, and I see hundreds of kids who want to gather and learn how to read, because it turns out that kids everywhere love books. We shipped lots and lots, hundreds of thousands of books in English so that kids would have something to read in Ethiopia. But I saw that kids really want to learn how to read in their own local language. My daughter and one of my sons learned how to read in their own language. And when they were in college, they decided to volunteer in Ethiopia. And my son ended up getting married to an Ethiopian woman who was working at the book center. So then I got a chance to visit and meet my first grandbaby. And I got to meet the other side of her family, my daughter-in-law Hewitt's family. And then pretty soon, she had a little brother. So that's another way that I've been learning about Ethiopia, through my daughter-in-law and through my grandkids. And through the whole time we've been sharing books. So when I got an idea that I wanted to start a new project called Ready, Set, Go Books with local language books for Ethiopia, my granddaughter helped. and my grandson helped, because that way they got to learn about their own Ethiopian heritage, even though right now they live in the United States. My daughter also helped. She's the one who did the illustrations for this book. It's been a family project. And I keep learning more and more about Ethiopia through these books. I've learned more about football or soccer. I've learned more about the coffee ceremony that people use every day to celebrate coffee. I've learned about the animals of Ethiopia. I've learned more about the cities of Ethiopia. I've learned about customs of Ethiopia, like how people wear their hair. I've learned about the important things that people are doing to plant new trees and try to save the earth in Ethiopia. I've learned about the history of Ethiopia, people that I really didn't know very much about until these Ethiopian authors and illustrators created their books. Through the whole thing, it's been super important and super helpful that there are Ethiopians and Americans working together on the team, both putting in what we know and what we love to create books. The Ready, Set, Go team has been working really hard. We have almost 100 books created now and available online in Amazon and also traveling to Ethiopia. It was really exciting to see Ethiopian kids reading the Ready, Set, Go books for the first time, to see how much they loved them, to see how much they liked seeing their own lives in the pages of books, to see adults sharing the books with kids, to see girls and boys loving the books and learning how to read better. So I'm really thrilled that you're learning a little bit more about Ethiopia through E is for Ethiopia. It's a way that you can help. It's a way that you can learn more about your world. And maybe someday you'll get a chance to share books or school with the whole world too.